JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for May the 13th. I am Charalambos Pissouros, senior market analyst here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar continued outperforming all but one of the other G10 currencies on Wednesday and during the Asian session Thursday. It gained the most versus SEC, NZD, AUD, and JPY, while it was found virtually unchanged against the Canadian dollar. The strengthening of the US dollar combined with the weakening of the risk-linked Aussie and Kiwi suggests that markets continued trading in a risk-off fashion yesterday and today in Asia. However, the weakening of the Japanese yen points otherwise. Thus, in order to get a clearer picture with regards to the broader market sentiment, we prefer to turn our gaze to the equity world. Here, although major EU indices ended their session slightly up, the US ones finished well in the red, with Nasdaq falling the most. The negative appetite rolled over into the Asian session today as well. Yesterday, the main item on the agenda was the US CPIs for April. The headline rate jumped to 4.2% year-over-year from 2.6%, exceeding the 3.6% forecast, while the core one rose to 3% year-over-year from 1.6%. The forecast was for the core rate to jump to 2.3%. The more than expected surge in inflation may have intensified speculation that the Fed may have to start normalizing its policy, its monetary policy earlier than previously thought, and that's why equities continued to tumble and the US dollar kept strengthening. Nasdaq tumbled the most given that high growth tech companies are valued based on earnings expected years into the future, and thus when expectations over higher interest rates rise, there is more concern that the discounted present values of those companies will decline. Despite some Fed officials sticking to their guns ahead of the release that any surge in inflation is likely to prove to be temporary, those who spoke after the release appeared slightly more skeptical. Fed Vice Chair Clarida said that he was surprised by the CPI report and that if inflation proves not to be transitory, they will use their tools to bring it under control. However, he also added that the CPIs are just one data point, as was the jobs report, which was a downside surprise. Atlanta Fed President Rafael Bostic was also a bit vague, just noting that it's too soon to judge whether the inflation trend is worrisome, avoiding to say confidently that the surge is due to transitory factors. As for our view, a lot will depend on what other Fed officials have to say moving forward. If more of them appear a bit skeptical following yesterday's data, the stock market is likely to continue retracing, while the US dollar may continue to strengthen. On the other hand, if the consensus among them is still that the inflation spike will prove to be temporary and that it is still too early to start discussing withdrawing policy support, risk appetite is likely to return to the market. Equities and other risk-linked assets are likely to rebound, while the US dollar and other safe havens are likely to come under renewed selling interest. Now, as for today's events, following yesterday's US CPIs for April, today we get the US PPIs for the month. Expectations are for both the headline and core rates to jump to 5.9 and 3.7% year-over-year from 4.2 and 3.1% respectively. But bearing in mind the upside surprise in the CPIs yesterday, we cannot rule out a similar reaction in the PPIs today. Initial jobless claims for last week are also coming out, and the forecast points to a small decline to 490,000 from 498,000. We also have five speakers on today's agenda, and those are Bank of Canada Governor Tiff Macklem, Bank of England Governor Andrew Bailey, Bank of England Monetary Policy Committee Member John Cunliffe, Fed Board Governor Christopher Waller, and St. Louis Fed President James Bullard. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm hosting every Monday at 7 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. At this point, I have to let you know that there will be no daily market review tomorrow. So goodbye, have a great day, a great rest of the week, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again next week.
JFT, just fair and direct.